hubby is having a potluck at work. They do it about once a month lately, so his contribution is smoked ribs, baked beans, coleslaw, and tarts. So I'm going to make the rub, the tarts, the coleslaw, and the baked beans. Yeah, I know. He's going to cook the ribs. It's nothing. He's got to go to work early. So he's not going to get hardly any sleep. All right, so I just made my pie crust and I put a video up. This is pie crust for two pies. I'm just going to work with half at a time. It keeps turning off. I don't know why. All right, I'm just going to roll it. Yes, I have no counter space. I'm going to roll it out. And I'm just going to press it. I'm not going to cut it into rounds or anything. I'm going to press it into the pie tins or the brioche tins. Okay, I have to move the camera so I can do this because I'm crowded. Can you see those yummy little specks of butter all throughout there? And even little specks of lard. Yes, lard. There's so much fat in the pie crust, we don't need to grease these brioche tins. So just pick up a hunk, stick it in, push it in, press it into the little groovy thingies. See? Don't worry if you say, oh, it's cut too big. Don't worry about that because, you know, I save pie scraps, pie crust scraps. I do a lot with them. Okay, take a look at number 7. It's patched to smithereens because the dough is too soft. Because my kitchen's so warm. Okay, back in the fridge. Good thing I have extra dough. Let's see how I can screw this up. Oh, not bad. So let's say you're cutting out 5 million sugar cookies. If you have a Silpat or a fake Silpat, I have Smart Chef. I love it. It's as good as a Silpat and it's like one third the price. Okay, lay your Silpat down, roll out your dough, put it in your cookie pan, cut your shapes out and then lift up your scrap dough. Just lift it up and you'll have perfect cookies that you don't have to peel off the top or whatever. These I will have to peel because they're going on individuals. They're not getting baked. Okay. I'm putting a tablespoon or so of pecans in my tarts. 5 of them. Just grind them up. Whole nuts don't work as well as ground up nuts in this particular little tart recipe. And the filling will be too much for all this, but that's okay. Okay, Frankie Valley's here. Sorry, but I can't go and touch the computer with all my filthy fingers. All right, USDA pecan pie. Half of a recipe for 5 little tartlets. 2 eggs, a half of a cup of white sugar. I've got a teeny weeny pinch of salt. I've got almost 3/4 of a cup of white corn syrup. And I made up the difference with molasses. Why? I didn't have quite enough. With the corn syrup, you can use light, you can use dark, you can mix them up, you can add some molasses, but long as it equals 3/4 of a cup. Secret tip when you're baking and you have to measure super sticky stuff like, you know, corn syrup, molasses, honey, golden syrup, whatever. Spray the inside of your measuring cup. Okay. Did I tell you to put the butter in there? What do I have? I have a tablespoon and a half of a teaspoon of melted unsalted butter. Now, I'm going to mix this up and then I'm going to put some vanilla in. How much? calls for a half a teaspoon for a half of a recipe, but I'm going to use a little bit less than that. It really doesn't even need it. And then I put, instead of one cup of pecan halves, I used about a tablespoon in the bottom of each tart shell. Okay? I'm going to do the cherry tarts first, and I'm going to keep them at 425. These have to go in at 350, and then as soon as you put them in, you lower the temperature of the oven to 325. And they could take half hour to 45 minutes for each, the cherry and the pecan. I know my dad eats pecans. My mother ate pecans. Okay, the reason I'm going to do the pecan pie last is because when you use any force whatsoever to mix this, you get bubbles. Don't want bubbles in it. Let them sit and break up by themselves. So by the time the cherries are done, this will be ready. And let's see, it's pushing 6 o'clock. Now I'm going to put some lemon juice and some almond extract. I have pure almond. And I'm going to use that, just a drop or two, because that stuff is so potent. Use almond extract for like three different things, usually. Almond bars, cherry pies, and what's the other thing I use it for? Oh, French toast. Oh. That's it. Scotchy bit. Itty bitty scotchy bit. Then I'm going to just take my knife and stir. Now you can just wet the top of the little pie disc and sprinkle some coarse sugar on it, which I sprinkled the tops with Trader Joe's organic coarse sugar. I forgot to turn you on. All right, just pour it over the little crushed nuts. Give it a couple hundred whacks. Let the bubbles come up. Are they not lovely? I'm not going to sugar these because they're sweet enough, trust me. They did overflow. It's going to be a real pain in the butt to get them out of those tins. I'm so wiped out. These are still screaming hot. Ouch, ouch. Cute, huh? I'm very disappointed in the cherries, but we'll see how they are when they're completely cool and I cannot pop them out of the tart tins.